Hi, this is Greg Bafidas, the founder and chairman of the Posse List. I'm here at the Georgetown University Law Center for the continuing conference on law firm evolution. Is it a brave new world or is it business as usual? My guest this afternoon is Joshua Kubicki, who is with the Legal Transformation Study. Joshua, tell us about the study.
The study was, it's about 3 years old now, and in these terms, in these times, that's a long time. The study was basically, we've heard a lot about scenario planning, looking to the future, trying to predict where the industry is going to go. The original study was just that. It was a collection and examination of current trends in the legal industry, and then using scenario planning to forecast out what the different elements of the legal industry could look like in year 2020.
And there's how many people involved in it?
Oh, there's dozens and dozens. Everyone from economists to Wharton to obviously legal vendors. Jeff Carr here was a major contributor, as well as myself.
Okay. And your role in it?
Was really an expert contributor, I think is the title I carry in it. And that at that time was heavily involved in project management and staffing, so represented that component and sort of where that industry is going and the place it holds in the industry as all.
Okay. Does it have a website? Are you coming out with white papers or anything of that sort?
Well, there's sort of two components to this. The original study is at legaltransformation.com, a group out of Minneapolis Legal Research Center. Jim Seidel basically owns this study now. What I'm trying to do with fellow thinkers in this space is really take it to the 2.0 version, update it.
Okay. We've heard a lot of this conference about the opportunities that are going to be available to many different kinds of companies that are in the legal services provision space. What is your take on that?
Oh, I think it's an exciting time. I'm one of the ones that believe that the true innovation is and will continue to come outside of the traditional legal realm, whether it's LPO, whether it's the litigation funding groups. The avenues for innovation are just expanding. If you look at the UK market, which is something I've been involved in more so recently, there's just lower barriers to competition in the legal services market as opposed to the US. And so we're seeing tremendous innovation over there. How much of that will creep into the US? It all depends on the rate of globalization and how much US Western focused law will transform and migrate into China or India once those barriers are lowered. So the innovators, the entrepreneurs, are really the ones that are going to continue to drive this. And hopefully that'll permeate some of the law firms too. As again, in Australia, we've seen a law firm go public already. It's a mixed bag of review on that, but just witnessing that sort of new thinking and dynamics is exciting.
You said that there was an attendance here at the conference, several members of the study. Who else was here, you said?
Jeff Carr, the general counsel for FMC Technologies. There's a few others that escape my memory right now. As far as what I'm doing now, I was actually just speaking to a number of people here at the conference in sort of updating the study, which is what I mentioned, taking it to the 2.0 version. The original sort of set the table, but it left a lot of the subject areas of diversity, of true globalization, of, I mean, even the Legal Services Act in the UK, I think was mentioned in passing. Again, it wasn't the focus of the original study, but certainly those areas are inviting more researchers we've witnessed here at this conference. And taking that and encapsulating it around a legal transformation study, whether it be white papers, blogs, events, we're not sure yet where we want to go. We just know there's an interest. I'm trying to construct the vehicle now for that.
Okay. Besides the study, what else are you active in?
I do a number of things, actually. I'm a consultant with LPOs, currently working with a technology, fascinating technology company in Pittsburgh, that is linguistic and analytics based, doing some amazing things with the University of Toronto up there in analyzing content in new ways. They're applying that in the legal realm. And also continue to write and blog regularly, actively involved, obviously everyone says it, with the Sedona Group, but we actually have a new paper, potentially new working group with Sedona that is more IT focused than anything Sedona has done before. We presented a draft at last year's ARMA conference. Hopefully we'll be presenting the final version at this upcoming ARMA conference as well.
Great. Joshua, thank you very much for taking the time to meet with us.
Thanks, Greg. Appreciate
Bye.
It.